Sup, this is Kelly. Basically, since our last Let's Play through the portal is now over, Jen asked if anyone had suggestions of what else we could play, and quite a few people suggested Slender. Now, if you don't actually follow Jen and I on things like Tumblr, or you don't actually bother reading any of our responses to things, you wouldn't know this, but both Jen and I have played Slender, and both of us think it's kind of shit. Despite the fact that so many people seem to be absolutely cacking their pants over it. Now, anyone who's watched me through the portal or has seen the videos of our Amnesia Let's Plays that we live streamed will know that when it comes to games, I am a bit of a wuss. I don't play horror games, hardly ever. So, when this came out and everyone was ranting and raving over it because people had done playthroughs of it and scared themselves shitless, I thought, okay, well, give it a go, maybe it will be scary. I was wrong. This is quite possibly one of the least scary games I have ever encountered in my life. The original Silent Hill games used to scare the tits out of me, but this one barely got a shudder. So basically the premise of this is, you're stuck in this forest. Despite there being a chain link fence, oh, we can't see the chain link fence. Despite there being this chain link fence, it's, you know, reasonably easy to climb over. You've decided not to. Instead, you're wandering around by yourself in the dark with a torch, looking for these random pictures. Like, I could draw better pictures than these, and that's saying a lot because I suck at drawing. I'm not entirely sure what the point of it is. But yeah, that's what we're doing. You have no weapons. You have no way to defend yourself. Your running is limited to this, which tends to cut out after a little while. And all the while, you're trying to avoid Slenderman. But, I don't see why you would want to avoid him. I'm gonna be perfectly honest here. There's some weird building over there that has absolutely nothing in it. So we won't bother with that. I am literally trying to find Slenderman just because I want this video to be over so I can prove why we're not doing a playthrough of this game. For some reason, despite my loud running around and flashing of flashlights, he's not very interested in me. I honestly don't know if he only crops up at certain locations or if he can turn up anywhere. Say ugly face. Nondescript face, really. Is that him? No, that's a page. Let's go grab it, because I think that kind of encourages him to come a creeping. I could be completely wrong, but maybe it doesn't. I can't jump, I keep trying to jump. As if that'll make me move faster. But yeah, you can actually see what these pages are. So these are the pages we're collecting. Follows. And then the music becomes a little bit more intense. Pretty much the entire atmosphere of this game is set by the music. Every tree looks the same. So, you know, if you're one of those people who tries to figure out some landmarks based by surroundings, looks like, yeah, you're not going to do too well on this game, because clearly this is some weird tree testing facility where they're just breeding identical trees. Oh, come on, where are you? The thing is, I'd just run up to this guy and batter him in the face with my torch. But apparently that's not an option. Nor is running like a regular human being, but we'll ignore that for now. Slenderman, where are you? I am bored of this game. There's also weird things like this in the middle of the forest, like random plus sign shaped wall. Serves zero purpose. No idea if it has any page things attached to it, let's find out. Hey look, it's that super high fence that I am incapable of jumping over. Page. No. That's pretty much my response to when people tell us to do Let's Plays in this game. Saying that, here I am, doing a Let's Play. And there's Slender Man. Then we just hang out here. That's it.